I can only imagine.
Good morning and welcome to Asbury United Methodist Church. It is a joy and a blessing to be in worship with you on this somewhat brisk Sunday morning. We hope that wherever you are, that you are warm and comfortable and ready to engage in a wonderful time of worship. I'm Nick Schimmer. I'm one of the pastors here at Asbury. My colleague, Pastor Dee Dee Roberts, will be along shortly to deliver today's message on Transfiguration Sunday, that powerful moment where our Lord Jesus Christ on a mountaintop revealed himself to a stunned group of disciples. We hope that today during this time of worship that you are transformed in a way that may be surprising to you, but will also bring you incredible joy. As we continue on with our worship this morning, please join me in a quick word of prayer. Gracious, loving God, we give thanks to you for so many things, but especially for this moment, this opportunity to gather as your children, as a community of believers, to come to you in worship and praise and God, to glorify your name. We ask that during this time this morning that you are with us, that through the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit, you move amongst us and through us, transform us into the children, the image of Christ that you call us to be, so we may then go forward and transform the world. We ask all this in your Son's beautiful name. Amen.
There is a promise that points beyond my failure. There is a still voice to silence all my fears. Even the worst of my mistakes, miracles in the making, the miracles in the making. By your stripes I am healed, with one touch I am made whole. You have spoken. By your stripes, I In the storm, you are peace, and your love won't let me go. You have spoken, and I know that it is so. Yes, Lord, you have spoken, and I know that it is so.
Will you join with me in a word of prayer? Oh God, as we come before you today, may you know our love for you is real. But even more importantly, may we know that your love for us is real as well. Today, on this day when we will celebrate with hearts and flowers and chocolates and cards and all manner of celebration of human relationship and the joy that we bring to one another, we pray that you would transform those feelings into commitments and action that speak louder than words. May our love for one another indeed be patient and kind, never boastful or envious, never seeking its own delight, but seeking what is best for others. May our love reflect your love in the world, a love that is self-giving, a love that is sacrificial, a love that lasts. Oh God, this day, we hear the story of that kind of transformative love, and we know that it is possible, that your love can change our hearts, that your love can change the world, that your love can make right what sin has made so wrong. Today we lift to you all anywhere who are cold or hungry or lack in anything. And we humbly ask that you would use us, the church, your church, to meet their need. We lift to you all who are ill or suffering from loneliness, the lack of relationship, the loss of health. We pray, O God, for your healing balm to be poured out upon them, that indeed you might make them well. And where you can use us in that ministry of salvation, we offer our hands, our hearts, and our livelihood. And oh God, as we as a nation face division, as we as a church face disagreements in our denomination, as we at Asbury face the unknown of new pastoral leadership. Help us to look to you for guidance and to listen in all the ways that you are communicating to us. Peace. Be still. So that we might trust your goodwill to be worked out in our lives, in the life of our nation, in the church and the world. God, our prayers to you could fall today like so many flurries of snow, but they can also be a blizzard. You, O God, alone know what we truly need. You, O God, alone know our heart's desires. And so we lift them all to you, even as we pray the prayer our Lord taught us to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I need to fix this a bit. All right. Well, it is so good to be with you today. Even though it may be for a short time that we actually see one another through the wonder of our ability to live stream, the snow has begun just with flurries here in Little Rock. I suspect it is beginning a much faster pace northwest of us. And so we're going to worship together and then kind of scoot on home. All of us who are here, both pastors and volunteers, so that we can be safe and warm this afternoon. So that means if you are counting on our weekly Bible study at 11:15-ish, let's meet back together on Facebook Live for that at 3 o'clock so that we can all make sure that we are where we need to be, safe from the storm. Well, today, our scripture lesson is, as we've talked about it, the story of Jesus' transfiguration. And here is Mark's account of that wondrous event. 6 days later, Jesus took Peter, James, and John and led them up on a high mountain to be alone. As the men watched, Jesus' appearance was transformed, and his clothes became dazzling white, far whiter than any earthly bleach could ever make them. Then Elijah and Moses appeared with them and began talking with Jesus. Peter exclaimed, Rabbi, it is wonderful for us to be here. Let's make three shelters as memorials, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. Now, Peter said this because he didn't know what else to say, because they were all terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and a voice from the cloud said, This is my dearly loved son. Listen to him. And suddenly, when they looked up, Moses and Elijah were gone, and they saw only Jesus with them. As they went back down the mountain, He told them not to tell anyone what they had seen until the Son of Man had risen from the dead. So they kept it to themselves. But they often asked each other what he meant by rising from the dead. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Well, there is a place, a holy place, made that way because of the many prayers that have been spoken at the top of a mountain. And the mountain overlooks a valley. And at sunrise, that valley is shrouded in fog. And depending on the day and the angle of the sun or the weight of the clouds, the fog over the valley can look like a lake or a moor or more mountains to climb. So much so that the mist seems to speak an invitation to look into this new day and to listen. To listen for God who is speaking through the fog, speaking with full clarity, so that what I see and hear that is just beyond my grasp, just beyond the solid rock of my experience, becomes apparent to me. This place that is thin like air. The transfiguration of Jesus is a holy mystery. Scholars see in it symbols and interpret their meaning. Mystics gaze into the scene and experience the profound presence of God with them. You and I approach with caution. We know there is meaning here. We recognize the presence of the holy that is palpable even through the distance of time and culture. For the transfiguration is a picture of that thin space where heaven and earth come together, where air is so thin that it becomes hard to breathe, where the mystery and the experience can never be fully explained, but can be and is revealed time and again in our lives of faith. Look, says the voice from the cloud, this is the Son that I love. Listen to him. Now, the transfiguration occurs at the midpoint of Mark's gospel. Jesus has called his disciples. They are itinerating through the countryside with him, preaching and teaching and healing. It has dawned on them that this is no ordinary rabbi. And so when Jesus asks them who the people think that he is, Peter is ready with a proclamation. You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus celebrates Peter's insight, but confuses him even more as Jesus begins to teach them what it means to be the anointed of God. what it means to be God's son sent by the Almighty to be the Messiah. It is not easy, Jesus teaches them, to conspire with the divine. The Son of Man will suffer and die. And the glory of the Messiah will be bound, hanged, really, on a cross. And we all know how Peter responds. He rebukes Jesus. He tells the very Son of God to stop saying that. Stop talking nonsense. Because the future Jesus is foretelling and describing makes no sense. What sort of God? The Almighty God would give up power and dignity and control in order to suffer and save. Moments of transfiguration come to our lives when our lives flash before us and give us a sense of perspective. Transfigurations are a nanosecond of clarity when we can look back on our lives and see how we got here and look forward to what is coming. For Peter and James and John, the mountain provided the vantage point for truth. They could see Jesus. They could look back at his baptism, his calling them forth, his teaching and the healings. And those provided the backdrop for what he said was coming in the future. Conflict, rejection, suffering, crucifixion. And in that moment, they could count the cost of their salvation without yet having to pay the price. Look, said the voice from the cloud, this is my beloved son. Listen to him. And they did, mostly. They followed him down the mountain. They went with him to Jerusalem. And they even remembered through their doubt and denial and fear. This mystery. The truth of the transfiguration that invited them beyond the firm footing of their own assumptions into the blinding light of God's presence. And brothers and sisters, this is our invitation today. You and I gather in worship at the midpoint of our grand story of salvation. We've spent the last several weeks in the season after Epiphany, celebrating the light of God's revealing love, challenging one another to follow where Christ is going. But now transfiguration marks a turn in our journey, as well as in the life of Christ. Today, we begin to move into the shadows of Lent. Shadows made possible because the light has made them visible. And so, beginning Wednesday, we will be called to move forward toward Jerusalem with courage and conviction, to admit that sin is real in our lives, to come to grips with the fact that we are mortal, and that all of us must accept our cross in order to gaze upon the empty tomb. Transfiguration is a time of seeing the mystery of God who comes to us, for us, a burning bush that is not consumed, a thundering silence in which we see God, a baby's mourning cry, the last labored breath of the beloved, a tomb where the stone is rolled away, and the simple celebration of bread and cup that become for us again the body and blood. We too are called down from our mountaintops. Jesus will lead us beyond what is comfortable. We will have to reckon with suffering. Everything we know about power will be turned upside down by the scandal of the cross, and our lives have to be redefined by the resurrection. The Holy Spirit will loosen our tongues to speak to power and witness to the mysteries of our faith, mysteries that are too deep for simple words. And yet, in that, we will meet God in all of it, because God is already there. Perhaps the greatest mystery of the Transfiguration is not how Jesus was changed, but how we can be transformed by Jesus. So I leave you with this, Elizabeth Barrett Browning's wonderful poem, "Earth's crammed with heaven, and every common bush afire with God, but only he who sees takes off his shoes. The rest sit around and pluck blackberries." Oh, my friend, may you see holy ground. Amen. As the band makes their way back, let us pray. Oh God, on this day of transfiguration, may we be inspired May we have eyes to see and ears to hear, that we seek you and you only, and allow you to transform us by the power of your love. Amen.
You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears are gone. I'm no longer a slave to fear. Oh, I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child. From my mother's womb, you have chosen me. Love has called my name. I've been born again into your family. Your blood flows through my veins. And I'm no longer for I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. For I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave. And I'm no longer a slave to fear. For I am a child. No, I'm no longer a slave to fear. No, I am a child of God. You split the sea so I could walk right through it. My fears were drowned in perfect love. You rescued me I could stand and see. I am a child of God. Oh, you split the sea so I could walk right through it. My fears were drowned in perfect love. You rescued me so I could stand and see. I am a child of God, and I'm no longer a slave to fear. No, I am a child of God. No, I'm no longer a slave to fear. No, I am a child of God, for I am a child of God.
Amen. What a joy and a blessing it's been to be in worship with you today. Please enjoy the snow. And what prayerfully and hopefully is the final push of winter, because I don't know about you, but I'm ready for spring. And speaking of that, we are on our way to Easter. The season of Lent starts this Wednesday, Ash Wednesday. Our plan for now is to offer drive-through ashes at 7 a.m. and 6 p.m. out in our parking lot. stay tuned with the email and the Asbury website and Facebook, and we'll keep you updated on that. Starting next week, we kick off Lent in the sanctuary. We'll be there through the Easter season, so we hope that you enjoy seeing our beautiful sanctuary starting next week. We have a plan this afternoon for a children's event at 2 o'clock. Weather permitting, just keep an eye on email and communication from Miss Mary Noble. She will keep you up to date on what's going on with that. Other than that, be safe today and stay warm. God bless you and receive now this benediction. Serve your God with patience and with passion. Be deliberate in living out your faith. Be steadfast in celebrating the Spirit that works within you, and may peace be your way in the world. God loves you. Go in peace. Amen. Thank you.